It has just turned 5 o'clock and Mary has just pressed record. So welcome to our Sunday evening Zoom service. It's an LA service this evening. So I'll just hand over to the LA team.
Our call to worship. Lord Jesus Christ, wisdom and word of God, dwell in our hearts, we pray, by your most holy spirit, that out of the abundance of our hearts, our mouths may speak your praise. Amen. I'm going to sing our first hymn, which is in Singing the Faith 94, To God Be the Glory. Our prayers of praise and adoration. Eternal God, we worship you, creator and sustainer of the universe. And we praise you for the gifts of life, health, and strength. Lord Jesus, we worship you, Saviour and Lord of the world. And we praise you that you have found us, washed us, forgiven us, and given us a place in your church. Holy Spirit, we worship you, sanctifier of the people of God, and we praise you that you have renewed us and blessed us with your gifts. Amen.
Now, our service this evening is based all around God's promises. And the Bible is absolutely full of the promises of God. Everett Storm, who was a Canadian school teacher, took 18 months carefully reading through the Bible. Apparently it was his 27th time of reading the Bible. And he identified 7,847 promises made by God to humankind. And altogether there were something like 8,800 promises in the Bible. In the Old Testament, the Hebrew language doesn't have a word that corresponds to promise, but instead it says, God said, or God's word. And the New Testament word for promise, epangelia, refers to the fulfillment of all God's promises through redemption in Jesus Christ. We also make promises. So, what kinds of promises do we make in our lives? Well, from the time that you're little and you promise not to eat those freshly baked cookies that are sitting on the side, to the major promises in our life, such as our wedding vows, baptismal vows, vows to our country, and at the moment, many Ukrainians are making promises to defend their country against whatever. We make vows and promises when we're confirmed. We make promises when we're scouts. And doctors take the Hippocratic Oath, promising always to care for people and not to harm them. Now, sometimes there are promises, like in elections, where politicians promise much that they can't always necessarily fulfill. If you have to take the witness stand, or if you're on jury duty, you have to make a promise. And a legal contract is a promise between two parties. Unfortunately, we can't always keep our promises. And so Helen is going to lead us now in our prayers of confession.
So let us pray. Lord, you have given us so much, and yet we give you very little in return. There are times when we make enthusiastic promises, but you know how they fade. We confess that our words, thoughts, and actions often deny our faith in you. Yet you continue to love and forgive us. Help us to turn our commitments into reality, matched to the people we are. And may our lives reflect your sacrifice for us. Amen. Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. This is his gracious promise. Your sins are forgiven. Amen. So we're going to sing again, Great is Thy Faithfulness.
Great is Thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not, thy compassions, they fail not. As thou hast been, thou forever. Thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord. Time and harvest, sun, moon, and stars in their courses above. Join with all nature in manifold witness to thy great faithfulness, mercy. Faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord. Sin and a peace that endureth, thine own dear presence to cheer and to guide, strength for today and bright hope for tomorrow, blessings all mine with 10,000 beside. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me.
So the first promise that God has made to us, God is for us. God is for us. We've got nothing to fear. He's promised to be with us always. Sometimes that can be really apparent. Other times, perhaps not so. But he is always going to be there. God has got our backs. And he wants what's best for us. Because at times, I'm sure I'm not the only one, when you can't see the wood from the trees, I'm just reminded, somebody has reminded me recently of something I said a while ago, which I thought I would repeat. Thank you to Ken for this. I talked about when we moved from a large house to a small house, how important it was for me to clear my huge attic. And it was Ken who said, just remember, Valerie, that you can You can eat an elephant, but one mouthful at a time. And I think that's a bit like God. Sometimes that's all we need to see, just one mouthful at a time. The other thing that happened on the day we were moving was things started coming into the kitchen. Yes, that was fine, but I had a real panic when my son said, "Come on then, mother, where's the kettle going? Where's the mugs going?" And I said, "I just don't know." So he saw that I was in a bit of a panic, and he very gently said to me, "Find a cupboard, put the kettle there, put the coffee and the mugs together." That was it, easy. And a couple of days later, my friend came down and she said, "Oh, Valerie, I see you've got a rotary washing line." "Oh, I'm going to get rid of that," I said. "Why?" "Well," I said, "I've always been used to using a long line." "Don't be silly," she said. "You just stand there and you turn it round. You haven't got to walk all the way up and down." Well, a new concept for me. But I knew what she said. So the elephant, small steps are all that's needed. God says, "Trust in me. I can see the broader picture." The kettle, "Keep me close," he says. "Keep the important things that you need together. I am all you need." And the washing line. "Go on, Valerie, try new things. Be open, not shut. Because you could be shutting me out," says God. I'm so grateful to Ken, to Pam, and to Andrew, because it's often God speaks of his promises in the most ordinary things, but I thank God for them. I'm just going to read some verses. The one from Peter. "And because of his glory and excellence, he has promised us great and precious promises. These are the promises that enable you to share in his divine nature and escape the world's corruption caused by human sin." And this one that I love. "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future." And finally, "But those who trust in the Lord will renew their strength. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not faint." Thank you, Lord, for your promises to us to be with us.
So we come to a time of intercession prayer. Let us pray. In faith, let us pray to God our Father. In the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, and in the power of the Holy Spirit. God of mercy, we earnestly pray for the people of the world, particularly Ukraine. For those exercising their selfish power over the weak and ignoring the many millions of people whose lives are being wrecked and are far from home. Show us how to live as members of the human family, to reject the ways of war, to bear each other's burden and to work together for justice and peace. Lord, great is your faithfulness and your promises that help us to know right from wrong. That we have hope and a future in the plans that you have for us and provide for all we need. For with your love, we have renewed strength to further serve you, listening for your voice and doers of your word. Lord, great is your faithfulness and compassion. Thank you that you walk alongside us, even carry us when we are weary and burdened, and give us rest. We pray for those who are ill or anxious at home or in hospital. For those whose lives are filled with fear and despair. For those grieving for loved ones. Draw near with your saving love and bring healing and hope. Lord, great is your faithfulness. We pray for the life of the church. May every congregation be a community of love and every Christian a witness to your grace. May we be a living fellowship in your spirit and serve our neighbourhoods. Thank you, Lord, that you love and value us enough to commit yourself to us. Help us to take your promises seriously and to trust you for our present and future. We pray our prayers in the name of Jesus Christ, our Saviour and Redeemer. And we say together the prayer that his disciples were taught by Jesus. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. So we're going to follow our prayers by singing Blessed Assurance, Jesus is Mine.
So we've seen how God has promised to be for us. And in addition, he's also promised to be with us. In the Old Testament, God led his people, but he didn't often meet them face to face. But with Jesus, the incarnation, God with us, Emmanuel, in his birth, in his growth, and in his death and resurrection, he's God himself sharing with us in all of our human life, in our problems. He understands our feelings. He understands our temptations. And he promises to be with us always. And so, Angela, to read some verses about God's promising to be with us.
So from Matthew chapter 11, verses 28 and 29. Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. And Matthew 28, 19 and 20. Go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always, to the very end of the age. And from Romans 8, 37 to 39. No, despite all these things, overwhelming victory is ours through Christ who loved us. And I am convinced that nothing can ever separate us from God's love, neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither our fears for today nor our worries about tomorrow. Not even the powers of hell can separate us from God's love. No power in the sky above or in the earth below. Indeed, nothing in all creation will ever be able to separate us from the love of God that is revealed in Christ Jesus our Lord.
God is for us. God is with us. But God also is in us through his Holy Spirit. Most of the promises of the world, and so too the promises of most religions are contractual. Even in the Old Testament, promises were exchanged. If you do A, then I will do B. What makes Jesus' promises special is that they are promises of grace, one-sided, and wholly undeserved. He came to complete what could not be accomplished by us, promising us healing, peace, hope, and joy, while he gained nothing in return. These promises could only be received through the presence of the Holy Spirit. The Spirit of the living Christ alive in us, in our hearts. And this Spirit comes at a price, at a cost to Jesus. His death on the cross. The Holy Spirit cannot come unless I go to the Father. Yet the transformation that the Holy Spirit releases in us is the only power strong enough to prepare our hearts to know God and to receive him fully. The promise and the presence of the Holy Spirit is the culmination of God's work of redemption, the sign, the seal, the fruit of his promises fulfilled. In our God, we have a helper, a guide, a Lord who will be with us always and in us always, in all situations, till the very end of the age. And the two readings I have to share are John 14, verses 27, and Luke 24, 44 to 49. The Helper, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything and make you remember all that I told you. I am leaving you with a gift, peace of mind and heart. And the peace I give is a gift the world cannot give. So do not be afraid or troubled. Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures and said to them, "This is what is written. The Messiah must suffer and must rise again from death 3 days later. And in his name, the message about repentance and forgiveness of sins must be preached to all nations, beginning here in Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things, and I myself will send upon you what the Father has promised. But you must wait in the city until the power from above comes down upon you."
So God is for us, with us, and in us. So what about our promise to God? What does God ask of us? Very simply, God asks us to believe. To believe that he is for us. God asks us to believe that he is with us every moment of our lives. And God asks us to believe also that he is in us. His spirit is in us. We just have to trust and listen and follow. It's not asking much, is it? To believe, to have faith, to walk the way that Jesus showed us. This is the way to do it. Love your neighbor. Love everybody, because your neighbor is not just the person living next door. Find it difficult to pray at the moment because I've been thinking, yes, I want to pray for Ukraine, but I can't pray for Ukraine if I don't also pray for Russia, because that's the way God works. God, we say God is for us, but the us includes everyone, every person, whether we like them or not. They are still a child of God. Yes. God is wonderful. God is fantastic. God is unimaginable. And all that God wants is for us to believe and to follow. And so our next hymn is going to be, "Be Thou My Vision." Because Jesus has given us a vision of the way we need to travel, the way we need to be.
Be thou my vision, O Lord of my heart, not be all else to me, say that thou art, thou my best thought, by day or by night,
Everybody unmute so that we can say the grace to and for each other. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, evermore.
Amen.
Thank you.
Thank you.
See you for pancakes on Tuesday at 7 o'clock at church.
Find the tickets.
Bye.
Yep. Bye. See you there. Bye, everybody. Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye.